Hi, welcome to my channel. In this video, we want to solve the following problem. ABC is a sector of a circle with a central angle of 60 degrees. AD and CD are chords of the circle. Next, construct equilateral triangles ADE and CFD. And then, connect B to E and connect B to F. Given that BE equals 10 units and BF equals 9 units, our goal is to find the radius of the circle. And now for the solution. First, connect A to C and then consider triangle ABC. Since AB and BC are the radii of the circle, we have AB equals BC. And triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle. But angle ABC is 60 degrees. Thus, the triangle is an equilateral triangle. Therefore, we have AC equals AB equals BC. Next, connect C to E, and then consider triangles ACD and ECD. Let us show that these triangles are congruent. To do this, consider the minor sector and the line segments AD and CD. The central angle of the major sector is 360 degrees minus 60 degrees, or 300 degrees. Recall that an angle at the center is twice the angle at the circumference. Hence, angle ADC equals 300 degrees divided by 2, or 150 degrees. Next, consider these four line segments. Angle ADE and angle FDC are interior angles of equilateral triangles, and thus equals 60 degrees. Angle EDF is then given by 360 degrees minus 60 degrees minus 150 degrees minus 60 degrees, or 90 degrees. Angle EDC thus equals 90 degrees plus 60 degrees, or 150 degrees. Returning to our two triangles, since AD equals ED, CD is common to both triangles, and the included angles are equal, by the SAS congruency test, the two triangles are congruent. Since AC and EC are corresponding sides in congruent triangles, we have AC equals EC. Next, let's define angle DAC as alpha and angle ACD as beta. Then, since angle ACD and angle ECD are corresponding angles in congruent triangles, we have angle ECD equals angle ACD equals beta. Following this, consider triangle BCE. Let's apply the law of cosines to this triangle. Given a triangle with sides A, B, and C, and let the angle opposite side A be alpha, then the law of cosines tell us that A squared equals B squared plus C squared minus 2BC cosine alpha. Applying the law of cosines to triangle BCE, we obtain BE squared equals BC squared plus EC squared minus 2BC times EC times cosine of angle BCE. If we let the radius be R, and noting that BE equals 10 units, our equation becomes 10 squared equals R squared plus R squared minus 2R times R cosine of angle BCE, or 100 equals 2R squared minus 2R squared cosine of angle BCE. Next, let's obtain an expression for angle BCE. Recall that angles ACD and ECD both equal beta. And since angle BCA is an interior angle of an equilateral triangle, it equals 60 degrees. Thus, angle BCE equals 2 beta plus 80 degrees. Our equation therefore becomes 100 equals 2r squared minus 2r squared cosine of 2 beta plus 60 degrees. Following this, connect A to F and then consider triangles ACD and AFD. Let us show that these triangles are congruent. Recall that angle ADE is given by 60 degrees and angle EDF is given by 90 degrees. Thus, angle ADF equals 60 degrees plus 90 degrees or 150 degrees. Since AD is common to both triangles, CD equals FD, and the included angles are equal, by the SAS congruency test, the two triangles are congruent. Since AC and AF are corresponding sides in congruent triangles, we have AF equals AC. Similarly, angles DAC and DAF are corresponding angles in congruent triangles. Thus, angle DAF equals angle DAC equals alpha. Next, consider triangle ABF. Applying the law of cosines to this triangle, we obtain BF squared equals AB squared plus AF squared minus 2AB times AF times cosine of angle FAB. Since BF equals 9 units, our equation becomes 9 squared equals R squared plus R squared minus 2R times R cosine of angle FAB, or 81 equals 2R squared minus 2R squared cosine of angle FAB. Next, let's obtain an expression for angle FAB. Recall that angle CAD and FAD both equal alpha. And since angle CAB is an interior angle of an equilateral triangle, it equals 60 degrees. Thus, angle FAB equals 2 alpha plus 60 degrees. Our equation therefore becomes 81 equals 2r squared minus 2r squared cosine of 2 alpha plus 60 degrees. To proceed, let's find the relationship between alpha and beta. And so, let's consider triangle ACD. Since the interior angles of a triangle sum to 180 degrees, we have alpha plus beta plus 150 degrees equals 180 degrees, or alpha plus beta equals 30 degrees. Thus, 2 alpha plus 2 beta equals 60 degrees. The sum of 2 alpha plus 60 degrees and 2 beta plus 60 degrees, which can be rewritten as 2 alpha plus 2 beta plus 60 degrees plus 60 degrees, therefore equals 60 degrees plus 60 degrees plus 60 degrees, or 180 degrees. If we let theta be 2 beta plus 60 degrees, then we have 180 degrees minus theta equals 2 alpha plus 60 degrees. Plugging this into our equations, we obtain 100 equals 2r squared minus 2r squared cosine theta, and 81 equals 2r squared minus 2r squared cosine of 180 degrees minus theta. Since cosine of 180 degrees minus theta equals minus cosine theta, our second equation becomes 81 equals 2r squared plus 2r squared cosine theta. Adding the two equations, we observe that the terms with cosine theta cancel out, and we obtain 4r squared equals 181. After dividing both sides by 4, and then taking the square root, we obtain r equals square root 181 over 2, which is the solution to our problem. As an exercise, try to solve this problem and see if you can get the correct answer. This marks the end of the video. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like and subscribe to my channel for more content. Thanks for watching and see you all next time.